If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Hi Bobcats, and welcome to our Veterans Day Assembly. Our focus this time will be respect, and I want you to think about how we can respect our veterans and everything that they've done for our country and for our community. So Bobcats, enjoy this assembly and have a great weekend.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'll pick my battles 'cause I know I'm gonna win the war. I'm not rattled 'cause I shattered all of this before. Steadier than steel 'cause I'm ready with my shield and sword. Back on the saddle 'cause I gathered all my strength for more. And I won't bow, I won't break. No, I'm not afraid to do whatever it takes. I'll never bow, I'll never. 'Cause I'm a warrior, I'll fight for my life like a soldier all through the night, and I won't give up, I will survive. I'm a warrior, and I'm stronger, that's why I'm alive. I will conquer, time after time, I'll never falter. I will survive, I'm a warrior. I'll be fighting through the day and night, oh. I'll be marching through the darkness till the morning lights. Even when it's hard, I like the armor, you will see me shine. No, I won't stop and I won't drop until the victory's mine, oh. And I won't bow, I won't break. No, I'm not afraid. Do whatever it takes. I'll never bow, I'll never break. 'Cause I'm a warrior, I'll fight for my life like a soldier all through the night, and I won't give up, I will survive. I'm a
I'm a warrior.
And I'm stronger. That's why I'm alive. I will conquer. Time after time, I'll never falter. I will survive.
blood will dry underneath my nails, and the wind will rise up to fill my sails. So you can doubt and you can hate, but I know no matter what it takes, I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming. Still far away from where I belong, but it's all coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming. I'm coming.
was in the Marines for 20 years, and my older brother, he's 19, and he's been in the Marines for 2 years now. And one thing I really like is that they risk their lives and they give us freedom for other people. And yeah.
My granddad and my uncle served in the Coast Guard, and my dad served in the Marine Corps, and I'm grateful for them because they risked their lives to save our country.
A veteran is my granddad, and he served in the Air Force. And what I love about him is how loving, sweet, and kind he is, and caring.
A veteran is somebody who fights in the military, and when they get out or retire, they are a veteran. And I actually know two veterans, my grandma and grandpa, and they actually met in the military. And I love them because they're always there for me.
Who is a veteran?
He's in the United States,
A veteran is a person that works,
yes,
like in the Air Force or military, or
Do you know anyone who is a veteran?
My dad is.
Mrs. Shugel.
Mr. Shugel. Yeah.
My dad is.
My mom is.
Is he either in the Air Force or military?
Why do we honor veterans?
Because they help our state and they protect our state.
Yeah, and they check those cases.
Warthogs are just so rude. First, I got pushed in the corridor.
Oh, goodness, is your corridor all right?
My corridor? No, Harry, a corridor is a bougie word for a hallway.
I was nervous.
No. First, some Slytherin person, Blitherin, or whatever it is, they pushed me when I was in the hallway, and then they didn't even say sorry. And then in class, some Cravenlaw laughed at me when I raised my hand and asked the teacher a question. They told me I was daft.
What?
Can you believe it?
Daft?
Daft. And then again in the corridor.
Oh.
Still a hallway.
Oh, okay.
Someone from Driffenroar stuck their foot out and tripped me and knocked all the books out of my hands.
What?
And they didn't even stop and help me pick them up.
Oh,
and it was quite a lot of books, Perry, because you know I'm very smart. Yes, well, now I'm trying to use my wand to make them nice. Respecto Patronum. Don't be mean, abracadabra. Expellia be niceiness. It's not working.
You just can't magic people into being respectful. Respect has to come from the heart and the head. People who have want to be respectful and wanting to be respectful isn't enough. They have to practice it over and over and over again. That way they are creating respectful reputations.
Wow, Perry, such big words coming out of you. Respectful reputation.
Gee, Jemima, are you making fun of me?
No.
It's not very nice. I'm not very respectful.
Sorry, I was only joking, Perry.
Well, you know, even if you didn't mean to, you hurt my feelings. It's not only a joke if everyone thinks it's funny, but make sure that it is showing respect. Sometimes I might not think it's funny and everybody else would. That's still not respectful.
Well, sorry, Perry Hunter. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
Thank you.
I'm sorry if I was disrespectful. Let me try again. Do over? Okay. Here I go. Respectful reputation. That's great use of alliteration. Brilliant, Perry.
I love it. Thanks, Jemima. That was very respectful. What's alliteration, by the way?
Oh, well, Perry, alliteration is when
Mind. I don't have... Let's keep going. I don't want to do that.
Okay.
But I do have an idea.
What's your idea?
If warthogs are going to be respectful, let's change schools.
Change schools? Where should we go, Perry?
We need to go to a place that I've heard of. Gladden Farms Elementary.
Gladden Farms?
I hear they have very respectful students there.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Let's go.
Ready? One, two, three. Evaporate. Ooh, Perry, we're not at Warthogs anymore. No, oh, and look, a student!
Oh, hello, you must be new here.
We are! Come on over and tell us.
Yes, we are new here. Thank you for stopping and asking.
I'm glad to have you here at Gladden Farms Elementary.
Thank you!
Nice. Wow. You know what? You were right, Perry Hunter. These students at Gladden Farms are super respectful.
Good job, Bobcats!
Picking positive pot learners from the respectful list. First, we have Kinder, and for Kinder, we have Mia from Bruna Kent's class. And in first grade, we have Mariah from Arneson. Second grade, we have Jude from Adams. Third grade, we have Evelyn from Neil. Fourth grade, we have Caleb from Miss Wheeler. Fifth grade, we have Nino from Giretti. Sixth grade, we have Kinley from Murano. Great job, guys. Bye.
Hi, Bobcats. Thank you for watching today's Veterans Day Assembly. We want to say thank you to all our veterans in our community, and we want to show them respect and thankfulness if we do come across any veteran that may be associated with the school or just out in the community. Bobcats, I just want to remind you to be respectful to one another, to take your turns, keep your hands to yourself, and use kind words everywhere we are here on campus. Thank you, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your week. Go Bobcats!